Installing plugins in Final Cut Pro is a simple and straightforward method, or at least it should be. Unfortunately, a lot of people have been having all sorts of issues when trying to install plugins. Today, we'll take a look at an alternate, albeit slightly more difficult method of installing plugins. Even though this method is a little bit more difficult and takes a little bit longer, if you're having issues installing plugins using a simple method, this might solve your problems. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. If you've never tried installing plugins in Final Cut Pro, I would strongly recommend using a simple method. I have a video about that on my channel, I'll link up here and in the video description below. If you have tried it and had issues, this alternate method might help you out. Let's take a look. Over here, I have a Final Cut Pro Transition Pack plugin I downloaded from Ryan Angle. Most plugin downloads come as a compressed file, so first thing we need to do is double click it to unzip it. If we open this folder, you can see there's 5 transitions in here. Inside each one of these folders, you'll normally have a couple thumbnail files, a media folder, sometimes a preview movie, and a plugin itself, which in my case is a transition file. Select this file, click on it once to rename it, and add .motr to the end of the name. If your plugin comes with more than one effect, like mine, you have to do a step to every one of them. So I'll go back to my previous folder, open my second transition, and add .motr to the end of my transition file. Close this Finder window. Next, open another Finder window, and open the Applications folder. If you don't see it in your sidebar, from the menu bar select Go and Applications. Inside this folder, scroll down to Final Cut Pro, right click on it, and select Show Package Contents. Open the Contents folder, then Plugins, Media Providers, MotionEffect.fxp folder, Contents, and Resources. Inside this folder, scroll down and find the Templates folder. When you open it, inside you will have 4 more folders named Effects, Generators, Titles, and Transitions. It's very important to place your plugin in the proper folder here. For my example, I know my plugins are Transitions, so I'll open the Transitions folder. Now, drag and drop your downloaded plugin into this folder. Depending on your security settings, you might have to enter an administrator password to modify files inside this folder. So before installing any plugins, make sure you get them from a reputable source. Click Authenticate and type in your administrator name and password. Next, close Finder, and if you have Final Cut Pro open, close it and restart it. Open your Transitions browser and scroll down until you see a category that's the same name as your downloaded folder. When you select it, your transitions will be in here. You can now apply it to your clip just like any other transition. And as you can see in my timeline, it seems to work perfectly. Try this method out and let me know if it works for you, especially if you've had problems before installing plugins in the Motion Templates folder. If you are still having issues, send me a couple of screenshots to info@lptguy.com, and when I have a few spare minutes, I'll see if I can help you out. If this method does work for you, I want to hear about it in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.